Hello Excel Champions, it's William aka Dr. Excel. Today I'm going to show you which formula to use in Excel to detect if a cell contains a typical value that we want to detect. So it's kind of a formula that we could call if contains. I'm going to show you how to build this in Excel. I'm going to show you how to make it, and you can download the final file with the formulas already entered. This way you can follow with me and improve the file if you want afterwards. The file is going to be right below the video. I'm going to put the link for you to download as usual. So I have a set of some text here that I entered. I want to detect if it contains an R. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to begin by searching this character in the cell. So I'm going to use the function search, and I'm going to search the text I want to find, which is R, the string R between quotes, in the text within which I want to search, and it's going to return different kind of values. What does it do, search? It returns the position of, first position of this substring. So if I find an R in the string, it's going to return the position. So for Arthur, it's going to be character number 2. For Bird, it's going to be character number 3. And if it doesn't find it, it's going to return an error here, a value error. So that's how we use the search function. And how am I going to use this to improve the search function to return whether or not we find the character? I'm going to check whether it's a number, or if it's not a number, it's going to be an error. But if it's a number, it means I found it. If it's an error, it means I didn't find it. So we're going to check, is it a number? Is it a number? So with the function isNumber, this search. And here, of course, it's an error. It's going to return false. It should return true for Arthur and Bird. And that's basically what we have here. The function search is going to be an error everywhere we have false and true for, and we're going to get true for Arthur and Bird because it's going to return the position. Now, what happens, for example, in Arthur when I have a capital A? If I use the same formula with isNumberSearch with an A, I'm going to search for an A. What's going to happen here? Here it's going to find it as well with search. Even if I look for A, for lowercase a. So it means that the function search, actually, it's not case sensitive. So it's going to match Arthur, Baby, Melinda, even if we have capital letters. So in that case, it's gonna work if we look for A in lowercase or A in uppercase. If we want only A in lowercase, we have to force this, and we're not going to use the function search, but something close. We're gonna use the function which is called find, which behaves the same way, but it's not case sensitive, or it is case sensitive, which means it find will not match the with find A in lowercase will not match Arthur. You see here it's only gonna work for Baby and Melinda. If I rewrite the find function here, what did I do? I just want the find function. I'm gonna copy this equal find. You can see it only works for Baby and Melinda. It doesn't find A here because it's case sensitive. So that's how you match if one cell contains a value with you take isNumber of find of search the string in the substring in the string. Now, what you can do after, you can use this criteria in an if formula. For example, you can say, if the cell contains true, contains an A, then calculate something. And if it doesn't contain A, you do you do something else, what you're gonna do, you're just gonna use this criteria. For example, we're gonna print okay if we match the string. So we're gonna do equal if we match, if the cell contains the value we're looking for, then we're gonna print, we're gonna return okay, and otherwise we're going to return not okay. That's kind of simple function, but then you can improve and put everything you want. And it's going to return a value based on whether we find an A or not, like this. So that's how you build the criteria, and then you can reuse it in any if formula or in any kind of calculation. So I'll leave you download the file. I'll let you download the file right below. There's going to be a link for you, and you can access everything. And I'll see you tomorrow for a new Excel tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe. This way you will get notified as soon as I publish it. See you, champions. Bye-bye.